start with the poem I always start with, which is the poem that the book's named after, Nigh-No-Place. I will meet you at Pity Me Wood. I will meet you at Up to No Good. I will meet you at Stank, Shank and Sty. I will meet you at Blowfly. I will meet you at Low Spying How. I will meet you at Salt Pie. I will meet you at Copper Top. I will meet you at Scandal Bottom. I will meet you at Crackpot Moor. I will meet you at Mucker. I will meet you at Dirty Peace. I will meet you at Booze, Alberta. I will meet you at Bloody Vale. I will meet you at Hunger Hell. I will bring you to New Invention. I will bring you to Lucky Seven. I will bring you from Shivery Man. I will bring you the Lion and Lamb. I will bring you to the North Light. I will bring you to quiet the night. I will bring you to hush. I will bring you to hungry hushes. I will bring you to Grace, Alberta. I will bring you to Nigh-No-Place. I will meet you at 2 o'clock creek. Will you go with me? Sooner or later, I get to the point where I have to read a poem about my cat. It's always fun. This is a poem from my cat, Sophie, who I don't have any more. She was hit by a car right outside my house, which was pretty horrific, as you can imagine. But when I had her, she was a total nuisance for wanting to run out into the storm, and the weather is pretty extreme in Shetland in the wintertime especially. But she would want to go out whether there was a gale blowing or not. And having gone out, she'd want to come straight back in again. And we'd act like that for hours and hours. So this is a poem for Sophie and stands for me for a lot of the unlikelihood of what I do for a living. In the same way she cries at the kitchen door and I slip her and she runs into circular squalls of rain. And she cries at the kitchen door with snail tracks of rain in her muscular fur. So I open up and she runs in singing. And she cries at the kitchen door. So I open up and she crouches and then sprints into the wind. And the wind cries at the kitchen door. So I open up and call and call. And she doesn't run in, but the wind does. With rain, a squall of claws. In the same dogged, idiotic way, I open up and I send good night across the brae. And the wind canters in, and she with a wild calm, and all the night hail melted, gleaming in her furs. Now I'll just read you a couple more, I think. Daed-traa is a Shetland word that I have yet to identify in the Shetland dictionary, but my neighbour assures me that it exists and means the slack of the tide. I go to the rock pool at the slack of the tide to mind me what my poetry's for. It has its ventricles, just like us, pumping brine like bull's blood, a syrupy flow. It has its theatre, hushed and plush. It has its little shop of horrors. It has its crossed and dotted monsters. has its cross-eyed beetling leer. It has its billowing Munro. I go to the rock pool at the slack of the tide to mind me what my poetry's for. For monks, it has barnacles to sweep the broth as it flows with fans, grooming every cubic millimetre. It has its ebb, the easy heft of rack from rock like plastered, feverish locks of hair. It has its flood. It has its welling god with puddled, podgy cheeks and jaw. It has its holy hiccup, its minute silence, Daed-traa. I go to the rock pool at the slack of the tide to mind me what my poetry's for. I'll just close with the poem that I like to close with. I don't know why I'm so habitual, I need to finish and end with the same poems always, but I like the routine of that. This book has a lot of poems based on liturgical rhythms, which is why I described it as kind of a multi-faith book at the beginning, because it's a sort of a secular sacred. And the line, it is on earth as it is in heaven, it is on heaven as it is on earth, crops up a couple of times. Paternoster, Paternoster, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy draught work be done, still plough the day and give out daily bray, though heart stiffen in the harness. Then sleep hang harness with bear bells and trot on bravely into sleep, where the black and the bay, the sorrel and the grey, and foals and bearded wheat are waiting. It is on earth as it is in heaven. Drought, wildfire, wild asparagus, yellow flowers on the flowering cactus. Give our daily wheat, wet whiskers in the sonorous bucket. Knead my heart, hardened daily. Heal the hoof print in my heart. Gives our oats at bedtime and in the night, half sleeping. Paternoster, Paternoster.